Yes, hello everyone. Welcome to the second session of today. In the last session, we have calculated example number 3. In this session, we are going to solve example number 2. And in this session, we are going to solve example number 3. Alright, so let us read the question first, which is there with you already. So, let us have a look at it. 10% preference shares, 3 lakhs. The Aero Limited's balance sheet is given. Equity shares 3 lakhs, reserves 90,000, P&L account 25,500, debentures 1,20,000, creditors, bills payable, outstanding expense, provident fund. At the asset side we have goodwill, building, machinery, furniture, provident fund investment, 10% debentures of I don't know the name exactly, limited. Face value is 36,000 and the amount is 34,200. Stock 24,000. Debtors less PDR is 16,800 in the outer column and cash and bank 8,700. We have given the additional information. The present market value of building is 4,27,200. The average annual profit of the company before tax at 50% is 1,68,000. The expected rate of return on company's capital employed in this type of business is 10%. And the value of goodwill of the company has been ascertained at 45,600. From the above particulars, ascertain the fair value of equity share of the company, right? The example is almost like our previous example. So I have taken this example back to back so that it is easier for you to understand, right? So mostly adjustments are also common and the name of the assets and liabilities are also identical, right? So let us get started. We are required to ascertain the fair value. This example was asked in April 2015 in Saurashtra University examination. And the example courtesy is also for B.S. Shah Prakashan. So now for finding out fair value, we need both the values, intrinsic value as well as yield value. So starting with intrinsic value first. For intrinsic value, firstly we need to calculate our net assets. Okay, so how can we calculate net asset? Total assets minus total liability. So let us have a look at our total assets first. So here only the new value of building is given and new value of goodwill is also given. See guys, whenever the new value of goodwill is given or anything related with the goodwill is given in the adjustment, the balance sheet value of goodwill has no use at all. So no entry for the goodwill amount which is given in the balance sheet. So directly I am writing the new value 45,600. Then new value of building is also given. So building 4,27,200. Okay. After building, just take the sequence of the balance sheet. Machinery value rupees 3,60,000. Furniture $18,000. Then PF investment 30,300. Then 12% debentures of blank limited. The book value has to be considered. Alright. Stock 24,000. Next, debtors less VDR. Either you can take the outer column amount like I have taken, or you can take the total debtors at the asset side and you can deduct the VDR as your total liability, right? And the last one, cash rupees 8,700. So let us make the total of all this 45,600, 427,200, 3,60,000, 18,000, 30,000, 34,200, 24,000, 16,800, and 8,700. The total comes to 9,64,500. Okay, so this is the total assets. Deduct kariye total liability from this. So the liabilities are starting with 15% debentures, rupees 1,20,000. Then creditors 15,000. Then bills payable 7,500. Outstanding expense 12,000 and provident fund 30,000. Alright, all these liabilities are taken at their book value. So let us make the total 1,20,000, 15,000, 7,500, 12,000 and 30,000. That is 1,84,500. Now deducting 9,64,500 minus 184. So the product is 7,80,000. Okay. Don't forget to deduct preference share capital, which is given 3 lakhs. This is 3. So the answer of my net asset is 4,80,000. This is my net asset. Okay. Now intrinsic value formula: net asset divided by number of equity shares. So number of equity shares are given 30,000. 3 lakhs equity share of rupees 10 each. So 30,000 shares. So 4,80,000 rupees of net asset divided by 30,000 shares. So answer will be 16 rupees. So my intrinsic value of share is 16 rupees. Net asset is 4,80,000 and number of equity share 3 lakhs divided by 10. So that is 30,000. So my intrinsic value is rupees 16. Okay. Now second, yield value. So for yield value, I require percentage of dividend. So as I don't have the percentage of dividend directly, I need to calculate by using the formula. But before that, I need my divisible profit or adjusted profit. See, in the examination, we have given the average annual profit of the company before tax is 1,68,000, right? Before tax is given. So for that purpose, firstly, let us write down profit before 50% tax, rupees 1,68,000. Directly we can deduct tax at 50% of the same. So 1,68,000, 50% is 84,000. So remaining amount is 84,000, which is called profit after tax. Okay. After that, deduct preference share dividend at 3 lakhs into 10%. So 30,000 has to be deducted from the same, and we can get the divisible profit at rupees 54,000. So this is called my divisible profit or average adjusted profit for the purpose of valuation of share, right? Now I can find out my percentage of dividend. So formula, rate of dividend or percentage of dividend equals to divisible profit divided by equity share capital into 100. As we need percentage, so into 100. So my divisible profit is 54,000. My equity share capital is 3 lakhs. Okay, so the answer will be 3 lakhs. So percentages are 18%. So rate of dividend is 18%. Okay, now I can find out my yield value as percentage of dividend divided by expected rate of return into paid up value per share. So rate of dividend is 18%, expected rate of return is given 10%, and paid up value is also given 10. Okay, so the yield value, or we can say market value, will be rupees 18. Okay, so intrinsic value was 16 and market value is 18. Okay, dividend percentage 18%, expected rate of return is given in the example, and paid up value is 10. So that is rupees 18. And third, fair value formula, intrinsic value plus yield value divided by 2. So my fair value is rupees 17. So this is the final answer of my example. Alright, so this is the fair value of the share. So again, as per the last example, I am just changing the focus of the phone so that you can able to watch, you can able to see the whole example. See, this is the first page, right? Intrinsic value, net asset and intrinsic value. Okay, next, yield value method, which is again there in the on the screen. For calculating yield value, firstly we have calculated divisible profit, then percentage of dividend, and then yield value. And I have calculated fair value without writing the formula, that is rupees 17. So our final answer is rupees 17. Alright, in the next session we'll be solving another example of the same chapter, right? So till then, just write this down in your notebook. Okay, thank you all.